So welcome friends, today our topic is Photoshop. So in that we are going to see the selection tool. So we have our four basic selection tools. So first one is a rectangular mark view, and second one is elliptical mark view, and third one is single row mark view, and fourth one is single column mark view. So we're going to start with rectangular mark view tool. So first I'm just taking one image. So I'm just opening the image. So now I am selecting rectangular mark view. So the rectangular mark view, which is used to create a rectangular or square selection. So now we are going to make the rectangular selection. Once we made our selection, we can use for cut option as well as copy option. Here I have cut the image and paste it in the new surface. If you want to increase, use transformation option. So Control T is for transformation. So I have applied Control T and resize the image as much you can. So now we move on to our next tool, which is elliptical mark view. So the elliptical mark view is just used to create a elliptical or circular selection. I'm just taking one image. So I'm just applying the elliptical mark view tool. I'm just applying my selection. If you want to increase the selection, you can make it, or if you want to adjust the selection with the help of arrow keys, you can apply. So once you've done this, go to edit and cut the image. You can paste it to your new location or new surface, whichever you like. So this is what about elliptical tool. So now we move on to the next tool, single row mark view and single column mark view. So first we'll start with the single column mark view. So I'm taking one of my existing image from my system. So these are the two row mark view, single row mark view and column mark view. So I'm just taking my image. Yeah, now I'm opening the image. I just open. So now I'm going to apply single column mark view. So select the control, apply it somewhere in the image. It will take the entire column. So go to view, make it zoom. So then only you can able to see the selection, because it's very tiny. Unless until it is zoom, cannot able to see. So now you can able to see the selection, right? Go to copy. So open a new window, sorry, new work area. You can set your sizes, height and width, and go to edit and paste. So you cannot able to see because it is very tiny. So go to transformation, Control T, and expand the selection. So now you can able to see the selection, single column selection. I just wanted to make a duplicate of this, so simply so now I'm applying the same concept for the row. I'm just selecting single row mark view tool, apply in the image. Again I'm using the zoom, so now you can able to see the selection. Again I'm copying the selection and back to my new work area. I'm just pasting. So it is not visible because it is so tiny. I'm just resizing the selection with the help of transformation. So Control T is transformation, shortcut key for transform. I'm expanding the selection as much I can. So now I am taking duplicate copy of this, and again the row also making a duplicate. So I'm going to make a photo frame. So the main purpose of this, it's used to create a 1 pixel selection that span the width of the image. So the row, which is used to span the width of the image, and the column is which is used to span the height of the image. So that's a main difference between these two. So now I am copying this image into the frame. So open the image, I just copy the image and paste it here. This is one type of getting the image. If you have the image, you can open the image and copy the image or cut the image. You can paste wherever you want. This is one option. In another case, you have an option called place. So I'm just deleting this image. So go to file. That's the option called place. So select the image, and it will by default is transform is being applied. You can resize the image and fit the image into the frame. And that's it. So this is what about selection tools. So I hope this video is useful for you. So I will meet you in another video. So keep watching.